The greatest trick the devil ever pulled is convincing us that God doesn't exist. Because when you see how our existence is tailor-made for us, and how space is a lie, the millions and millions and millions of Earth-like planets are a lie. It is he who sits above the circle of the Earth, the circle of the Earth. Its inhabitants are like grasshoppers. He stretches out the heavens like a curtain. He spreads them out like a tent to dwell in. In our paradigm, in the new flat Earth intelligently designed paradigm, that is brilliant and spot on. In the evolutionary heliocentric globe Earth cosmic accident paradigm, it sounds ludicrous. So when Christians allow their normalcy bias to not, you said it, brother, you said Thomas wanted to put his fingers in the holes. Do you realize that everything that you've been told about space and star travel and about the way the Earth is and about evolution has been fed to us? Mm-hmm. It is not empirical science. It does not use the scientific method. The scientific method tells us that we make observations. From those observations, we create an hypothesis. With that hypothesis, we begin to attempt to isolate the variables. If we can replicate the observation, then we can draw a conclusion without a prejudice and without a bias.
Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about the solar eclipse, and specifically the solar eclipse of 2017. I get many emails and comments from globe believers telling me that the globe model predicts the eclipse and everything else, but the flat Earth model doesn't, and that is not true. And we're going to prove it. The globe model doesn't predict the eclipse at all. All the eclipse calculations are predicted by a guy, not by their model, and that makes a big difference. We're going to talk about this guy later. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to calculate the eclipse in the globe model using AutoCAD, and we will compare it with what they tell us, and then I will let you decide for yourself. But of course, if you see me doing anything wrong, don't get mad. Show me what I'm doing wrong, and I promise to delete this video if you convince me. Here is my email. Okay guys, so here is the NASA website that shows you where and when the total eclipse is going to happen. So I chose this area right here on that red line because I got a friend who lives very close to it and she can film it for us. So the exact time of the maximum eclipse is 1837 UTC. So what we are going to do now is go to suncalc.org and type in Brevard, North Carolina, and then change the date to 21 August 2017 and the time to 2037 Spain time, which is 2:37 p.m. local time of this area. Make sure you got the correct local time. So now if we zoom out, we're going to see that the sun is not 90 degrees on that area. It's around 62 degrees. And in order for the total eclipse to happen, the moon should be between the sun and Brevard. And if you draw a line from the center of the sun to that area, then the center of the moon has to be somewhere on that line, right? Now to locate the sun on the surface of the Earth, all we have to do is click on this circle and try to follow it. Keep an eye on the altitude of the sun. It has to be 90.00 degrees. I have already done that so as not to waste time. Here it is. So the sun is 90 degrees about this point. Please note that this is very precise, that if I click 1 inch near this point, the angles of elevation are going to change. So we have to be very careful. Okay. Now we have a clearer idea where the moon has to be, okay? Now what we're going to do next is go to mooncalc.org and do the same thing with the moon. I have already done that too. As you can see, the moon is 90 degrees above this area. The sun and moon are really very close to each other, but they are not on the same spot. And if we want the eclipse to happen on the USA, then they should not be on the same spots over this place. But the moon and the sun and Brevard, Carolina should be on the same line. Okay? Look at the latitude line. The moon is 1 degree above the sun, and this is cool. 1 degree is more than enough. Now, we don't have a problem with the latitude line. We have it with the longitude line. As you can see, the moon is many degrees behind the sun on the ocean. The sun is here, and the moon is here. So without using AutoCAD, you should already notice that the shadow should be cast on the ocean or in space, and not where they tell us, on the United States. And this is what I'm gonna prove to you. Just stay with me. So, to the people who think that the globe model predicts the eclipse, I'm gonna show you that the people who control this model admit that they don't. So we're gonna go back to the same NASA website and scroll down. Now check this out.
All eclipse calculations are by Fred Espenac, and he assumes full responsibility for their accuracy. Permission is freely granted to reproduce this data when accompanied by an acknowledgement.
God only knows what this guy uses to predict the eclipse, because if the globe model does predict the eclipse, why would we need this guy to predict anything for us? All we gotta do is check the model and see where the eclipse is going to happen, and that's it. But we checked the model and the calculations didn't add up. And I'm gonna prove this to you in 3D, just be patient. So, who is Fred Espenac? Let's find out who he is. Oh, he is a retired NASA astrophysicist. You get that? Retired. But NASA still goes back.